Yes, it's true. I have referred to the deceased as Milton, the melted man on several occasions. I have also referred to him as Charcoal Face. I suppose you could see it as disrespectful, but you know, as I understand it, human flesh it doesn't really melt. So Charcoal Face is a more accurate description, really. Yes, indeed. Mm-hmm. But I didn't mean no disrespect. Everybody knows there was no love lost between me and Milton. I only hired him to be a yard boy because we went to school together back in the 1960s. But even back then, I never really liked Milton very much. He's got a pretty bad reputation around town. People talk, you know. Okay, well, it happened like this. I hired Milton to mow the yard and do handyman stuff not so long after Hazel, my wife, ran away with that singer that she met down at Bud's, you know, that bar down on Travis Street. I don't know what she saw in that guy. He was a weasley little jerk. Thought he was some kind of Paunchy Perry Como with his plaid suit and all. Yes, sir. I'm sorry. It's just, it's so upsetting to me, you know. I hired Milton right after Hazel disappeared. I hadn't been feeling so good, and the lawn hadn't been cut for a while, and it would be nice to have somebody around, even if it was Milton, which was a big mistake. You hardly ever did any work. He just sat around drinking beer and asking me questions about Hazel, like, when was the last time I talked to her? And did I know where Flavio, that WAP singer, went when he left town? And maybe I should hire a private investigator to look for Hazel and stuff like that. I mean, it was personal stuff. Milton shouldn't have been asking me questions like that. It wasn't any of his goddamn business. I'm sorry, Your Honor. I'm sorry. I will not do it again. I'm sorry. Yes, the accident. Well, here is exactly what happened. You see, Milton was in the garage. I had him doing some refinishing work for me on the kitchen table. Oh, he hated it too. It was hot as hell in that garage, and he had to wear a respirator mask and coveralls and gloves, all that. I mean, he hated it, for sure. I was standing right outside the garage, smoking a cigarette, and I guess one of us, it could have been Milton, before he went in the garage. Well, anyway, one of us kicked over this gas can. Milton was going to mow the yard when he was done with the refinishing work, so the lawnmower and the gas can, they were sitting there on the driveway next to the garage, and one of us, it could have been Milton. I didn't notice when it happened, but it could have been Milton. Kicked over the gas can. And when I finished smoking my cigarette, I just tossed it on the ground, and it fell right in the spill gasoline. And kawoosh! Next thing you know, the whole garage was a blazing inferno. And I never saw anything go up so fast in my life. And there was poor Milton trapped inside. It was not pretty. I tell you that, Milton was just screaming like a skint puppy and beating on the door of the garage and all. I tell you, it was something. Somehow, the door must have got stuck. I don't know if maybe Milton leaned against it or what, but I tell you, I pulled and pulled on that garage door, and it was plumb stuck. I think I must have pulled my back out. It was just stuck. It was stuck tighter than a donkey dick in an ant's asshole. Oh, I'm sorry. I get all worked up thinking about poor Milton roasting in that garage. I think about him all the time. Gonna sound strange, but yes, I have told people that I have seen Milton several times since he passed away. Yes, sir, I know it sounds strange, but he has come back as, well, I guess you'd say he's come back as a ghost or a spirit or some kind of unearthly presence. It was just about a week or so ago after the accident when Milton just all of a sudden showed up one night while I was watching the Sports Center on the TV. And, you know, I watch the Sports Center every night. Hazel, she would get so upset at the end of the day when I turned on the TV and opened the beer. All she wanted to do was talk. Yak, yak, yak. Yak, yak, yak. That's all Hazel wanted to do was just talk. I wanted to watch the Sports Center. When was the last time I saw Milton? Well, to tell you the truth, Milton is here in the courtroom right now. It's true. Nobody can see him but me. That seems to be the way it is with this spook kind of stuff. But he is here. He's sitting right over there on that table right there, laughing his fool head off. He follows me everywhere I go. I mean, I can't go to the bathroom without Milton sitting there on the floor, bloodshot eyes, staring back out of that black, crusty face. He looks like some kind of laughing log that was burned up in a forest fire. And he sings. He sings, too. He sings all the time. Sings horrible stuff. It drives me crazy, like, my baby does the hanky-panky, my baby does the hanky-panky, and he sings like,
where are the clowns? There ought to be clowns.
Quick, send in the clowns. Ball. He keeps singing.
I'm coming, for my head is hanging low. I hear the gentle voices call, old black Milton.
And then he laughs again. I mean, it's driving me crazy. It's driving me crazy. I can't kill him again. He's already dead.